What is up, guys? I am VSkulls347. Now, I believe it is time to pick up.
Rachel Amber. She looks so hopeful and pretty. I wonder what happened to her.
Where we left off. So last time, we made a huge decision. We answered a few texts, and we left off literally pretty much right here. So, this is what's going to go down. We're going to continue.
Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive.
And if you guys are wondering which option I chose, since I didn't tell you in the last episode, I chose to hide the truth. And I think this is the wrong way. Yup. Well, isn't that some way how to start off the episode? So we are going to the dorms. Oh yes, this way. Now this man.
What is going on
today?
Important. I think his name is Evan. He always looks so intense.
Oh well. I think this is the way to the. Yeah, this is the way to the dormitories. Let's go. What are you doing? If you haven't hit like, subscribe button, oh my God, what are you doing? Yeah. I got my jug of water with me. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the episode so far.
I need to go to my room and return Warren's flash drive.
That was kind of a boring intro, but anyways. Yeah. Okay, here we go.
Oh look, it's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell. What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your waif hipster bullshit. The Daguerrean process, sir. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled. Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving. Oh, wait. Hold that pose. So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh yes, Victoria. Jeez. I'll get your bony ass out of my way.
What a bitch she is. Oh my, well some people would have to look and look and look for the situation. Well, look on me, oh Mr. Smart Boy. Now, if I use this right...
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Hold on. Oh, okay.
Awesome.
Oh, wait a second. Hold on. Hold on a minute. I got this. I got this, ladies and gents.
Oh, dude.
I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel. I just want to get Victoria the hell.
There goes Samuel da Vinci to paint the window.
No, I know that this has something to do with this.
No.
Okay, let's see if this works.
Let's do it. And then we crank this motherfucker on.
Nice, bro.
Hey, Victoria?
Oh, Samuel is sorry.
Yeah.
Wet paint is not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo.
Hold on. We'll get some towels. We'll be right back.
So move your ass before I dry.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches.
There we go. That's how you get it done.
Awesome.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
Oh my god. We gotta choose something. Comfort.
I am sorry. That's an awesome cashmere coat.
It was. But there'll be another.
Well, you always seem to know how to pick the right outfits.
I do have some talent. Mr. Jefferson told me.
I've seen your pictures. You have a great eye. Richard Avedon-esque.
He's one of my heroes. Thanks, Max.
Sweet.
I hope those sluts get me a towel before they hang a sign on me.
Dude.
You deserve a better shot.
Sweet.
Sorry about blocking you and the go fuck your selfie.
No.
That was mean, but pretty funny.
Just one of those days, you know?
I know exactly what you mean, Victoria. I'll see you later.
Au revoir.
And that's how you get to the campus. If you were stuck on that...
Victoria probably played me. I should have played her. Better get to my room before...
Ladies and gentlemen, I've played this game far too much to know all of the answers. But still, since this is a series where I'm doing it all over and I haven't played this game for so long, I memorized only a short amount of the things.
Hurry, Courtney!
Victoria is going to be pissed we took so long.
So that's the showers. Here we go.
How sad. I didn't write anything.
Now you
I have
did.
Nothing to say.
Pull out your marker and write something.
Obvious but true.
And this is the room. Oh man, I can get a good thumbnail from one of these.
Home sweet home. My favorite cocoon. Ahoy, Captain. At least I know you've got my back. When I swallowed your eye and my parents rushed me to the ER, I knew we were bonded forever.
Oh my, okay. Well, we guys can read this later. So we gotta get the goddamn... what is this to say?
Looks like Dana left me
I
a little
I borrowed your
me.
Drive so I can watch some flicks while I study. If you need a back, just track me down in my room. Okay.
Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive
Actually,
from Dana's
you want to do
room.
A few things while you're in here. I'm going to do a small time lapse. It's been a while since I've done
Philip
this.
Philip Lorca de Corsia, my
time
man.
Lapse.
I don't think I could take my camera to those places. Look at that shot. I love Julia Cameron's Victorian vibe. Talk about analog cameras. Ah, Dolly, what a fantastic eye. He could truly freeze time.
Yo, guys, that was an insane time lapse. It's been a long time since I've done that.
You can't get out now, Dana. So tell me the truth or rot in there.
Oh my god. This?
Welcome to the real drama queens of Blackwell.
Oh, Juliet, this is so stupid.
Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
You are ridiculous.
What did she do?
What did she do?
What didn't she do? Dana's been sexting with my boyfriend.
Ouch. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
I'm gonna take a guess here. Olson.
Juliet Olson.
That was truly sad. Thanks for your concern, Max Caulfield. By the way, Juliet Watson.
Okay. I was thinking about choosing Watson, but I didn't.
Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh, yes, Max.
Juliet Watson, you be nice.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do.
Thanks. I locked Dana in because she was sexting Zach, my boyfriend. Unbelievable.
If you don't let me out,
how do you know?
Victoria Chase. You know her.
You could say that. But why would Dana go after your boyfriend?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything, but I bet Victoria did. I know the proof is in her room.
I'm not letting her out until she tells the truth.
Oh my god. Okay. I know I don't usually do this.
Oh, Victoria, give me a fucking break.
Time to sneak into the... Alright. Her clothes, her shoes... TV... printer, computer... It'd be on the computer.
I'll give Victoria props for not posting my photo. And for this nice shot. Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here.
Dang right, you gotta goddamn print this. Wait, what? I thought that we just... Okay. Do not mind that. Oh, wow. Wow.
Victoria hates Rachel Amber this much? How insecure.
Well, we're gonna grab this.
This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent.
Her tablet? What?
Is she going to get a 3D printer for her dorm room? Maybe I will join her posse.
Wait, what the hell is this?
Ouch. At least she puts her photographs out there. Unlike me.
Alright, let's leave. And let's go show her.
Juliet, read this.
Of course. I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are. And I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Let's go grab that flash drive.
Almost done. Get the flash drive, and then I'll go see Warren.
Max, that's mine. Thank you.
Wait, that was not the...
You're not helpful. You're just nosy. I think you better go.
Oops.
Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Dana, I'm not trying to be nosy, but I heard a rumor about you.
What? Who told you I was pregnant?
Nobody important. They just acted like it was bullshit. I just wanted you to know.
It's like a goddamn reality show around here. Can you keep a secret, Max?
Of course.
I was pregnant. Was.
Oh. What about the other?
Deadbeat Dad? You can catch him on the 40-yard line this Friday. And it's not Zachary.
Who then? And you don't have to tell me. In fact, you better not.
I like your spirit, Max. Anyway, you better get that flash drive so Warren has an excuse to bug you.
All right then. Time to leave the... Oh my god. From you again? All right then. Let's skedaddle, leave the dormitories. Oh my god, that sounded so weird. Alright then, let's rock and roll.
Fuck this shit!
Ow! That hurt!
Damn, I better rewind.
Dang right.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody.
There we go. No time to speak.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Take a photo.
You can't fool me. I know everything about this school. I cover the waterfront. So you better figure out what side you're on.
Please, leave me alone. Hope you enjoyed the show. Thanks for nothing, Max.
What are you talking about? Wow, what a lovely game. That definitely didn't take fucking 30 minutes. Final one.
Man, I should have done something. That guy was an asshole.
Yo, Max, check it out. What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978 to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
Damn.
Really? I wish I would have known.
You probably could have raised a Kickstarter fund just for that one image of her covered in paint.
Had I known that. Anyway, Victoria took down my photo, so that drama ended well.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
Seen it. I was more disturbed by all those emo vampire movies in there.
Can a sensitive high school boy love sensitive vampires too?
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill.
Russ Meyer was a genius of black and white, plus babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I need to talk to somebody, just to get it out of my system.
Dr. Warren Graham is in the house. I won't even prescribe you any meds. Tell me everything.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you saw, now. Answer me, bitch!
Nothing but a butterfly.
You're full of shit. I'd respect you more if you told me the truth.
I don't need your respect.
You're clueless. You have no idea who I am or what I can do.
Actually, I have a pretty good idea of who you are.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
I could call the police.
Do it! The Prescotts own the pigs here.
Get away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that!
Or that whore right in the bathroom!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up and dangerous. This day never ends.
Check.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beat down for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Of course, it's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher? Not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
Give me a break. I was going through changes. Like you.
I guess those changes included dumping me from your life.
That's not true, Chloe.
Bullshit. You thought you hook up with all these art pricks in Seattle. Didn't happen, though.
You're merciless.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max.
Haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage. And he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max. Come on in, don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit home.
I'm loving it. I really am. I believe we are getting close to the end of the episode.
My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-fearer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
A house is a house.
Look at that. Chloe and her dad were so close. Houston, we have the power, but we need to find a disc to play.
Where are the discs exactly?
I think this junk swallowed her discs. Who'd have thunk Chloe wouldn't pay her parking tickets? She does love trouble.
Well, you'd think that it'd be over here.
We had such a blast drawing these together.
There it is.
Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
So, Rachel took my place. I'm glad she was there for you.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a
model.
If
only they actually
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
I see why. I bet your mom was not too happy.
She was happy enough to marry a Nazi. Reason number 356 to escape.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia.
That's kind of sus.
Without a word. Without me.
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now?
And to put in the CD.
Anyway. You can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment.
Well, see you guys. I've been to Skull C-57 and I'm signing off.